Hello, today we are going to be addressing the issue of water hammer for this washing machine. Throughout the wash cycle, this washing machine opens and closes the fill valves multiple times, and every time it closes that valve, you can hear a loud thud. That thud is, of course, water hammer, so we are going to be fixing that. The way we are going to fix this is by installing a water hammer arrestor at the hot and cold fill port of this washing machine. What we need for this job, other than the water hammer arrestors themselves, is a bucket, actually some cleaner. You might need some channel lock pliers, and other than that, just a towel and bucket to catch any water. What a water hammer arrester is it's basically just an air spring, which is inside this cylindrical feature. So when water is flowing through the water hammer arrester, it acts normally until the washing machine valve shuts. Then instead of all that water kind of slamming against the valve, because there's nowhere to go, and then resonating through your pipes, this spring is actually able to compress to give that water somewhere to go. Now that the valve is suddenly closed, a little bit of the water can go into the spring and relieve that that shockwave, so to speak, instead of it, again, relieving itself throughout your entire pipes in your house. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to make some space to be able to access the back of the washing machine. I'm going to move this dryer unit over to the right. So these modern washing machines, they're very, very heavy, and they have little rubber feet which make them very hard to move because they don't really want to slide against the floor. One neat trick that I learned a few years back is actually just to spray some cleaner around the feet. That way, you do it on all four sides. That way, once you start moving the washing machine, the little bit of cleaner, basically soap water, gets underneath the feet, and it's easier for it to slide along. Even if you can't get it underneath all 4 feet, that's okay. If you got 3 out of 4, that's quite good already. So. Okay, so now we have access. And I definitely do recommend making sure that you have appropriate access. Because if you don't and you're trying to do it blindly, there's a good chance that you'll end up cross-threading the connection. Next step is to make sure that both of your valves are off that lead to the washing machine. Cold and hot. So I've gone ahead and done the hot water, just so you can see a finished product next to what you're starting with. I've actually put a water hammer arrester just right over here and kind of tilted it a little to the side so you don't see it from the front of the washing machine. And now we'll do the same thing for the cold water. First thing you're going to do is loosen this fitting right over here. Loosen it by hand if you can, otherwise you can use your channel lock pliers to help it get started. Help it along just a little bit. Okay. Okay, the hose is off. Now we get our water hammer arrester. So we're going to install it just like that. I'm going to put the hose end on first. You can see that there is already a gasket in your fill hose. Make sure you don't lose that gasket, because if you do, it will leak. This water hammer arrester also does come with a gasket on the female side here that is going to go butt up to the washing machine.
Again, if the one that you get does not have a gasket, make sure you add one because it will leak without a gasket. Make sure it's threading on freely and it's not cross-threaded or anything like that. Tighten it. Again, ideally by hand. Okay. And then afterwards, you can always kind of move the hose around a little bit to rotate it to how it feels more natural for it to lie there. Now we do the same thing here. I'll need to use my second hand, so I'll need to put the camera down. Definitely make sure you get it started with two hands to make sure you're not cross-threading anything. This may be a little difficult to get tight, so I'm going to use my channel lock pliers just a little bit in order to tighten it, but make sure, because there is a rubber gasket, not to over-tighten it. Again, I'm just giving it a little bit of a nudge because I can't really get my fingers in there. Let's turn the water on and test to make sure that we don't have any leaks. Turned on slowly. I'd recommend feeling the underside with your hand in case you can't see anything. Looks pretty dry. I don't think we have any leaks. Okay. We'll do the same thing for the hot side, and after that, we will move the washing machine back. Over the course of the next day or few days, just make sure that you don't have any leaks once everything kind of settles in. You can do this obviously by moving the washing machine and just checking, or you can have one of these pucks that have metal contacts on the bottom. When water bridges the gap between the two contacts, the puck will send out an alarm. This one happens to be the one from Ring, so it sends an alert to your phone. So if you're not home, you also know about it. So I do like to have that one. Honestly, I like to put these in behind any washing machine, regardless if you've recently done new work or not. I just like the peace of mind of knowing if there's a leak in the house behind the washing machine. Okay, let's put the washing machine back.
So now I've moved the washing machine back to its original location along with the dryer. And now when you run the wash cycle, you'll see that it should be much quieter when it's filling the water, and you shouldn't have those loud thuds throughout the whole house. Thanks for watching. Let me know if you like this video or if you have any comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks.